Hello everyone, we are going to start the modern periodic table today. It is most likely to the Mendelius periodic table, but here the elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic number, not the atomic mass. Okay, so in 1913 Henry Moseley, Henry Moseley, okay, he discovered the atomic number. Henry Moseley discovered atomic number okay he discovered atomic number and we know atomic number were represents by Z, huh? So I am writing here Z. Atomic number is what? It is Z. Okay. With the help of experiment done by him, with the help of experiment. Okay. Experiment using X-ray tube. Okay, so in 1913 when atomic number were discovered, and what is atomic number? It is nothing but the number of electron or number of proton present in atom, in an atom. That is nothing but the atomic number. Okay, so what is atomic number? I'm going to define it first, because on that basis we have arranged all the element, that's why we had to understand atomic number also. So I'm writing here atomic number. So atomic number is the number of electrons, or you can consider proton also. So number of protons, okay, is considered as atomic number. Okay everyone, and somebody is in waiting room, wait a second. Sadab just came. Okay, and see, so have you understood atomic number, everyone? It is nothing but the number of electrons or number of protons present in an atom, okay, which is called as beta atomic number. Okay everyone?
Yes sir.
Yeah, so the number of electron or number of proton is considered as atomic number of the atom, or of an atom. Okay, so I'm writing the important point here. Okay, see, when Henry Moseley arranged all the known element in increasing order of their atomic number, most of the demerits of Mendelius periodic table were resolved. Okay, everyone. And he came with the new law called modern periodic law. And on the basis of he came with new periodic law. New periodic law named as modern periodic law. Modern periodic law. Okay, so now we are going to understand the modern periodic law. So I want everyone had to take a screenshot for that.
Done, sir.
Everyone done? Shadab?
Yes, sir, done.
Okay. See, so I'm just going to write the modern periodic law. Modern periodic law. So the law states that see, it is just it is as similar as Mendelus periodic law, only on the base, on the place of atomic mass we had to place atomic number. That's all, nothing more than that. Okay, so when elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic number, then physical and chemical properties of elements were repeated after certain interval. Okay, so on that basis he came with the new law called modern periodic law. Okay, so now I am going to write the statement for the modern periodic law. Okay, so the modern periodic law states that the periodic properties of, or the physical and chemical properties of wait a second. Okay, so the law states that the physical and chemical properties of physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic number and not the atomic mass. Okay, you are getting the point. Physical and chemical,
yes, sir,
properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic number and not the atomic mass. Okay, so this is the statement or the law given by the Henry Moseley in 1930. Okay, everyone, any doubt here?
Sir, can you explain the statement again?
Okay, so I'm just making you understand that statement in other word. Okay, so when elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic number, okay, then physical and chemical properties of element repeated after certain interval after certain interval. Okay, that means if we arrange element in increasing order of their atomic number, then after some interval the properties of elements were repeated. Okay, and he arranged all the known element in groups and periods form, that means in the form of table. Okay, so this is the modern periodic law. Now we are going to describe or define the modern periodic table now. Okay, so I am again take a screenshot here first.
Yes sir, done.
Everyone done?
Yes okay. Sir,
so now I am going to write the definition for modern periodic table. Modern periodic table. Okay, so see, table means the tabular arrangement. Okay, so the tabular arrangement of elements, the tabular arrangement of elements on the basis of modern periodic law, where physical and chemical properties repeated after physical and chemical properties of elements repeated after a certain interval. Is called as modern periodic table. Modern periodic table. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, any doubt till here?
No doubt, sir.
Sure. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the structure of modern periodic table. Okay, everyone do reply.
Yes,
yes sir.
Okay, so now the new heading, the structure of modern periodic table. Structure of modern periodic table. Okay, so I'm going to write all the points for structure of modern periodic table one by one. Before that, I'm just going to write the general or the block diagram for modern periodic table. So we have the modern periodic table like this. Somebody's in waiting room. Wait a second. Yogesh just came in the class very late. He became a latecomer. Okay. And here we have lanthanoids and actinoid series. Okay. So here we have the block diagram for modern periodic table. The periodic table look like this only. So here we have first group, here second, here third, then 4, 5, 6 up to 12. Here we have 13, then 14, 15, 16, 17, and here we have 18. Okay, so now we have total 18 group. Okay, and here we have periods. Yes, here we have one, the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So we had total 7 period and 18 groups. So here we got the 2 points. So in modern periodic table, first point here, very important, modern periodic table contain 18 groups and 7 periods. Okay, we have total 18 groups and 7 periods. Now, second point. First, we have to understand what are groups and periods now. So I'm just going to write first group. Next point for group. Groups are groups. So what are groups? Vertical columns in modern periodic table. So I am writing MPT all the time for modern periodic table. But whenever you will write, okay, on your notebook or in examination, you should use modern periodic table, not abbreviation for that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So vertical columns in modern periodic table are called as groups. Okay. They are 18 in numbers. They are 18 in numbers. Okay, and very interesting things about the group. What is the interesting thing? The number of group represents the number of electron present in their outermost shell. I will explain that. Wait a second. Let me write the point first. Number of the group represents number of electron present in their outermost shell or valence shell. In their valence shell. Valence shell is also called as outermost shell. Outermost shell. Okay. So let me explain you first. Suppose here we have hydrogen, okay, and we know hydrogen have atomic number 1. So in first cell, only one electron will come in case of hydrogen, is it? So I'm writing hydrogen here, we have 1. For here we have lithium. So we know lithium have atomic number 3. So if you will write atomic electronic configuration for lithium, it will be 2 and 1. Here we have it as sodium. So sodium have atomic number 11. So its electronic configuration will be what? It is 2, 8 and 1. Then here we have potassium. And potassium have atomic number 19. So if you will write the electronic configuration, it will be 2, 8, 8 and 1. So as you can see here, in outermost shell all the time, we have only one electron. Is it? That means that number of the group represents the number of electron present in their outermost shell. Okay, here we will take one more example for halogen. Here we have beta fluorine, and fluorine have atomic number 9. So its atomic or electronic configuration will be, it is 2 and 7. Then after fluorine we have chlorine, and chlorine have atomic number 17. So if you will write electronic configuration, it will be 2, 8, 7. So as you can see here, in outermost shell, say you just have to consider the unit plate digit, which is 7. For 18 you have to consider 8, the unit plate digit. Except helium, all the element will be here having 8 electron in their outermost shell. Okay, getting the point everyone? Do reply.
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So number of group represents the number of electron present in their outermost shell. So as we can see here, element from the group 2 having all the element 2 electron in their outermost shell. Okay, here we have beryllium. Okay, here we have magnesium, here we have calcium. So all element will have 2 electron in their outermost shell. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is all about the groups. Now we will discuss about the period. So now we will discuss about period. Period. Okay. So horizontal rows. Periods are what? Horizontal rows. Horizontal rows in modern periodic table, again I am using MPT, modern periodic table, are called as periods. Okay, and again interesting thing about period is, first we have to write the number. There are 7 periods in modern periodic table. And what is that interesting thing about periods? The number of period represents number of shells present in an atom. Okay, so as we can see here, for example, see hydrogen present in first shell. So hydrogen is having only first period, so hydrogen have one shell here. Okay, so I'm just writing structure. See, I'm just drawing structure here. It is a nucleus. So here we have first shell. For lithium we had two cells. See, 2 and 1, so we will require 2 shell like this. Okay, for third period element, here first element we have sodium. So sodium belongs from third period. So sodium is having 3 cells like this. For potassium, it belongs from fourth period. So having 4 cells like this. Okay, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So
sir, once can you write the examples for this?
Okay. Okay, so for example, okay, hydrogen and helium belongs from first period, hence they have one shell only. Okay, again somebody is in waiting room. Wait a second.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You guess. Okay, another example. We'll continue with. Then we have lithium. Then we have beryllium. Okay, then we have boron. Then we have boron carbon. Then we have nitrogen. we have oxygen, we have fluorine, and we have neon. They all belongs from, okay, from second period. Second period. Hence, they have two shells. Hence, they have two shells. Okay. Likewise, if we will take example here, here we have sodium. Okay. Then here we have magnesium. Then here we were having aluminium, then silicon, then phosphorus, then sulfur, then chlorine, then argon. All they have three shells around them, around the nucleus. Okay. Understood, Anudeep? Anudeep? Everyone understood that?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so here we have completed the group and the period. So again, I want you have to take a screenshot for that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we are going to discuss the next point. Okay, now we are going to discuss, I think this is the first point. Wait a second, let me just scroll it little aside. Yeah. So this is the first, this is the second, this is the part of second only, first and second. And this is the first point, this is second point. Now we are going to discuss third point. Okay, third point. See here. The first period having only two atoms, okay, hydrogen and helium. In second cell, in second period we are having only eight. In third also we are having only eight. On fourth cell, we are having 18 elements. You are getting the point? Here also on fifth period, we are having 18 element, and on sixth and seventh, we are having 32 elements in each. Okay, everyone? Do reply.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the first period is called as beta shortest period. Shortest period. Why? Because having only two element. Second and third is called as short period. Short period. Because having eight electron in each. Third and fourth period are called as long period. Because they are having 18 elements in each. And sixth and seventh period are called as longest period. I hope you understood the concept. Do reply. I'm waiting for your reply. You are not replying. You are
yes,
not
sir.
Active participation in the class. How will you understand the chapter then? Okay. So let me write 1, 2, 3, 4 point here. Okay. First period is called as shortest period. Shortest period. Okay. And having only two elements. Two elements in it. Then second and third period are called as short period. Short period. And having eight elements in each. Okay, then we have third and fourth period. No, third and fourth, it is fourth and fifth. Fourth and fifth period. okay, are called as long period, and they are having 18 elements in each. Elements in each. Then sixth and seventh period are called as longest period.
32 elements.
Yes, 32 elements in each. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now next point. See, I'm just erasing that so that you will understand the concept easily. Okay, see, elements of group 1 and 2, okay, they are called as beta S block element. Our modern periodic table is divided into 4 blocks. Okay, so elements of group 1 and 2 and helium is also there. Okay, they belong from the S block element. And then elements of group 13 to 18 are called as P block element. P block, here we have S block. And elements of group 3 to 12 are called as D block element. Okay, and element at the bottom of modern periodic table are called as F block element. Understood? Now, why they are called as S block element, P block element, D block element and F block element? So according to Aufbau principle and Hund's rule, okay, we will discuss in higher classes. You will go through that definitely. So according to them, suppose here we have first cell, second cell, third cell, fourth cell, fifth, sixth and seventh cell like this. So first cell may contain only 2 electron, then here 8 maximum, here 18, here 32 like this. Okay, so if 2 electron are present in first cell, 8 in second, so number of, as we can see here, as we are moving away from the nucleus, number of electron in the same cell increases. Is it or not? Is it? So due to increase in number of electron in a particular cell or same cell, energy difference between or within the cell increases, and that particular cell divides into sub shells. So we have total 4 subcells, S, P, D and F. So S, P, D, F are the 4 subcells we have here. If suppose elements of, suppose I'm taking sodium beta, sodium. So sodium having atomic number 11. So I'm just writing electronic configuration for sodium. It is going to be write like 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1 like this. Okay. So here we have, this is the first cell, here we have 2 electron. Here this is the second cell, 2s and 2p. So having 8 electron, and here in outermost cell, here we have 1 electron. See, electron of outermost cell get filled in S subcell, right? Is it? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So elements of group 1 and 2, they are called as S block element because electrons of their outermost shell here are filled in S subcell. That's why they are called as S block. If electron of their outermost cell get filled in P subcell, then they are called as P block. If they get filled in D subcell, then they are called as D block element. And if electrons of their outermost cell get filled in F subcell, then they are called as F block element. Very simple. Is it?
Yes.
Okay. So we have to write them also. Okay. So this is going to be our next point, the fourth point. Who left the class? Don't leave the class early. We had to complete all the important points here. So don't leave the class early. Okay. So fourth point. Modern periodic table divided into four blocks. What are they? First we have S block. Second we have P block. Third we have D block. And fourth we have F block. Okay, so what are S block element now? So electrons of outermost shell of an atom gets filled in S subshell. Okay, electron of outermost shell are get filled in S subshell are called as S block elements. So all the time you just need to replace, okay, electron of outermost shell of an atom get filled in S subshell. So instead of S subshell you had to write P, you had to write D, and you had to write F for S subshell for S, P subshell for P block, D subshell for D block, and F subshell for D block. Understood? That's all about S block, P block, and D block and F block. Okay, everyone. So now I'm going to write which element belongs to S block. So elements of group 1 and 2. Here elements of group 13 to 18. Okay, 13 to 18 here 1 and 2. Then in D block elements of group 3 to 12. Okay, and here element at the bottom of modern periodic table. Elements at the bottom of modern periodic table are called as F block element. Okay, and why they are called as F block element? Because electrons of their outermost shell get filled in F subshell like this. Everyone understood that important concept?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. So I want everyone had to take a screenshot for that. So here we have the modern periodic table, as you can see here. Okay. So the periods, they are 7 in number. And here we have the groups, they are 18 in number. So see here, the first period, here we have hydrogen and helium. So here we have only two elements. Here we have lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon. So if you will count, you will get 8. Here also 8. And here, these 10 elements, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, ferrous, cobalt, nickel, copper, and zinc. They are 8, and again, 10 are added here. Okay, so now we will have here 18. Okay, here also 18. But here, see, the actual position of this lanthanoid element. The actual position of lanthanum is here only. Okay, and after cerium, promethium, neodymium, promethium, then we have samarium, europium, gadolinium, terbium, diospium, then holmium. See, all this up to lutetium. their actual position is here only. Okay, but here we cannot place all these 15 element. That's why they got placed at the bottom of modern periodic table. Okay, so here we have 2, here we have 10, here we have 8, and they are 14. So 14 plus 8 plus 10 plus 2 equals to 32. Okay.
Yes, sir. So then why don't we consider the lanthanides and the actinides as D block elements? Because their actual position is there, right?
Yeah. See, lanthanum and actinum are D block element. But these element, okay, electron of their outermost cell get filled in F subcell beta, F subcell. That's why they are called as F block element.
Okay.
Yeah. Their actual position is here. If somebody will ask you what is the actual position of lanthanoid series element, so you would say third group and sixth period. For actinoids, seventh period and third group. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first is shortest, second is short, third is short, fourth and fifth are shortest, long, and sixth long. And seven are longest. Okay?
Yes.
Now, next point we will discuss in next class. So, just do present in next class, because again, in next class, we are going to cover the important point. Don't sir? Miss the next class. Yes?
Sir, you said that in the... Sorry. Yeah.